This is our normal-sized solar system. And this is what happens when all the planets become the size of the sun at the same time.
Baba boy.
Alright, first up, we're taking tiny Mercury and blowing it up to the size of the sun. Let's see how that completely wrecks the solar system. Looks like when Mercury hits a radius of about 1.5 times Jupiter's, it transforms into a gas giant. But crank it up to 3 times Jupiter's radius and boom, it turns into a brown dwarf. Take a look at how the orbits of the planets are warping. The sun's orbit has shifted closer to this sun-sized Mercury. Fast forwarding the simulation, the sun finally formed a binary orbit with the Mercury and the other planets going haywire. Bruh, look at the orbital paths of all the planets. Everything got messed up. As the sun starts binary orbiting with Mercury, all the planets are becoming unstable. Their orbits getting more and more chaotic. After a few years, we can see that only Mercury and the sun are left binary orbiting each other. All the other planets, except Jupiter, are gone, just drifting off into space. Without any sunlight, Earth's completely frozen, just an icy, lifeless rock floating in space. So, in conclusion, turning Mercury into a sun-sized object completely destabilizes the solar system. The sun and Mercury end up in a binary orbit. Most planets are ejected into space and Earth becomes a frozen wasteland. Now, let's do the same thing with Venus and see how everything plays out this time. So at about 1.48 times Jupiter's radius, Venus turns into a hot gas giant. Pretty wild. And when it hits 3 times Jupiter's radius, it becomes a brown dwarf. Let's make it one sun radius directly. As soon as Venus reaches a sun-sized radius, it starts pulling in the sun and the sun loses control, beginning to orbit Venus instead. Even though Venus and the sun are swapping orbits, Earth's still hanging in there. It could be because Earth's orbit hasn't been directly affected by Venus becoming a sun-sized object yet. But if this keeps up, things might not stay calm for long. Earth getting way too hot sometimes, then freezing cold other times. The unstable orbits and lack of consistent sunlight are really messing with its climate. So, in conclusion, Venus and the sun end up doing their own thing, binary orbiting each other. Meanwhile, all the other planets are slowly drifting away, losing their place in the solar system. Alright, this time I am going to make both Mercury and Venus the size of the sun and start the simulation at the same time. Let's see how that goes. As soon as the simulation starts, Mercury instantly turns into something like a pulsar. Those jets flowing from both sides. Yeah, that's a magnetic field at work. When Mercury reaches sun size, it's likely getting a supercharged magnetic field, causing those intense pulsar-like jets to shoot out. Mercury goes supernova because, after becoming sun-sized, the pressure and mass cause its core to collapse, triggering the explosion. It looks like only the Sun and Neptune survive this, with all the other planets turning to ash. As for Neptune turning into a rocky planet, well, it's likely because the supernova blew away Neptune's gas layers, leaving behind its dense core. That core would now appear as a rocky planet. So, in conclusion, after years pass, the supernova fades away and only the Sun and Neptune remain, though now they're separated, with everything else just a void. So, I fast-forwarded the scene and made Earth the size of the Sun. The results were pretty similar. Planets get destabilized and the Sun forms a binary orbit with Earth. leaving all the other planets behind. This happens because Earth's sudden increase in mass throws off the gravitational balance, pulling the Sun into orbit around it, while sending the other planets into chaos. Now, I've made all the rocky planets in the solar system the size of the Sun and started the simulation at once. Let's see how this messes with the whole system. Mercury and Earth turned into something like pulsars again, with jets blasting out. Venus and Mars, on the other hand, stay as brown dwarf-like planets. It looks like the massive increase in size turned them into highly magnetized objects, while the others just became huge, dense, and unstable. And there it goes again. Venus just went supernova like last time. The sudden increase in size and pressure triggered another core collapse, causing the explosion. It's interesting, right? Neptune keeps surviving the supernova because its core is incredibly dense and stable compared to the other planets. Even when its gas layers are blown away, its solid core remains intact, unlike the others that get completely destroyed in the explosion. The Sun-sized Mars surviving is pretty surprising. Its temperature shoots up to 1000 Kelvin, giving it a more orange-reddish appearance, kind of like a mini red giant. In conclusion, after the chaos settles, Mars, now a glowing Sun-sized planet with a temperature of 1000 Kelvin, drifts away on its own path. Meanwhile, the Sun and the pulsar-like Mercury lock into a binary orbit, stabilizing together but leaving the rest of the solar system in ruins. This shows how the massive transformations of planets completely reshape the dynamics of the solar system,